Hi guys, welcome on my channel Crochet with Jana. Today I'm going to show you another small size dolly. My is measured about 15 inches in diameter, and for this dolly we are also using 15 rounds. So 15 inches, 15 rounds. Dolly is quite easy to do, so even beginners can start this project. Only at the end we are working with double treble crochets, so this can be problem for the starters, but hopefully it gonna be alright. So I would like to thank you very much for supporting my channel through the Patreon site or my members to my YouTube channel, and also by watching all ads before and during the videos. So everything is very helpful. And now let's get started. Our work, we are going to start by making slip knot. And then chain of 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Slip stitch in first chain stitch to form a ring, and we are going to start first round. So we are going to start with chain of 2 instead of first part of the double crochet. Then into our circle, we are going to make two double crochets together. Actually, we can count it as a three double crochets together, because first two chain stitches we are counting as a first double crochet. So when you've got three loops, you can finish the stitch. Now chain of 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Into the second chain after our three double crochets, so 1 and 2, we are going to work slip stitch. So this is picot. Then chain of 2, and into the circle we are going to work another 3 double crochets together. So through first 2 loops only one time, and last loop need to stay on the hook each time. 2 and 3. 4 loops, we can finish the stitch. And again, chain of 5, 3, 4 and 5. Slip stitch into the second chain. Then chain of 2, and again 3 double crochets together. So this is actually our third group of 3 double crochets together. Into our circle we are going to make 10 groups and 10 chain spaces with picots in the middle. So now chain of 5, 3, 4 and 5. Slip stitch into the second chain stitch. Then chain of 2 and another group. So after our 10th group and the last chain 2 space, we are going to work slip stitch exactly at the top of our first group. Second round we are going to start by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet. So we are exactly at the top of our first group of 3 double crochets together. Then chain of 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Now we are going directly on the top of the next group, so chain space with picot in the middle we are going to skip, and we have to work double crochet. Chain of 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Double crochet at the top of the next group. Then chain of 7 again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Then double crochet at the top of the next group of 3 double crochets, then chain of 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. And the same pattern now we are going to repeat all the way around, but at the end, instead of our last chain of 7, we are going to work chain of 3 and treble crochet at the top of our double crochet. So I will go back in a minute to show you how we need to finish this round. And as I said, our round we are going to start by making chain of 3 and treble crochet in third chain stitch of our first chain 7 space. So basically this is our first double crochet. So By working this way, we are exactly in the center of our chain 7 space, and we are going to start round number 3 by working chain of 3 as a double crochet, then chain 2 as a chain 2 space, and one more double crochet in the same stitch, so at the top of our treble crochet. So our round, we are going to start with V stitch, now chain of 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Then we are going to the fourth chain stitch, 1, 2, 3 and 4 of the next chain 7 space. And again we are going to work V stitch, double crochet, chain 2 and another double crochet. Chain of 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, then into the next fourth chain stitch, 1, 2, 3 and 4, we are going to make another V stitch, double crochet, chain 2 and another double crochet. Chain of 6, 3, 4, 5, 6 and now this pattern we are going to repeat in each fourth chain stitch of each chain space, so at the end we should have 10 V stitches and 10 chain 6 spaces. Round number 4, we are going to start by making slip stitch in chain 2 space. Now chain of 3 as a first double crochet, chain 2 as a chain 2 space and in our chain 2 space one more double crochet. So basically we've got V stitch in our V stitch. Chain of 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Then into the next V stitch we need to work double crochet. Chain 2 and one more double crochet. Chain of 7 again, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, then we are going directly to the next V stitch and again double crochet, chain 2, then double crochet. So now chain of 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. And the same pattern now we are going to repeat all the way around. So we should have again 10 V stitches and this time 10 chain 7 spaces. Round number 5 again we are going to start by working slip stitch in chain 2 space and we are going to work another V stitch, but this time we are going to make chain 3 as a first double crochet and then chain 3 space, not chain 2 but chain 3. One more double crochet in the same chain space. Chain of 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Then we are going directly to the next V-stitch. V-stitch again. Double crochet. Chain 3. And one more double crochet. Chain of 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Then V stitch into the next V stitch, double crochet, chain 3 and one more double crochet. So now this pattern we are going to repeat all the way around V stitch in each V stitch and then chain 9 space. Round number 6, we are going to start by making slip stitch in our V stitch, then chain of 2 instead of the first part of the double crochet. In our chain space we are going to make 3 double crochets together. So one through first two loops two times and last loop need to stay on the hook each time. When we've got four loops we can finish the stitch, chain of 3, double crochet in the same chain space, chain 3, then four double crochets together still in the same V stitch. So 1, 2, 3 and 4. 5 loops we can finish the stitch. Now chain of 3. Double crochet in 5th chain stitch. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. 5. Chain of 3. Then into the next V stitch we need to work 4 double crochets together. So the same as we've done in our first one. 2, 3. And 4, 5 loops, we can finish the stitch. Chain of 3, double crochet in chain 3 space, chain 3 again, and another 4 double crochets together. 1, 2, 3, and 4. 5 loops, we can finish the stitch. And chain 3, again, double crochet in 5th chain stitch, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Chain of 3, and in next V stitch again 4 double crochets together, chain 3, double crochet, chain 3, and another 4 double crochets together. So this pattern now we are going to repeat all the way around. Now we are going to start round number 7, and we need to make slip stitch in first chain stitch, then slip stitch directly in our chain 3 space. Chain of 2 instead of the first part of the double crochet, and now into our chain space we are going to work 3 double crochets together. So we are starting around in exactly the same way as our previous one. 4 double crochets together, so we've got 4 loops, we can finish the stitch. Chain 3, double crochet in double crochet, chain 3, then into the next chain space, 4 double crochets together. 1, 2, 3, and 4. 5 loops, we can finish the stitch. Now chain of 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So we've done exactly the same pattern as in our previous round, but our groups of 4 double crochets together we've done in chain 3 spaces. Double crochet, we've got in our double crochet. Now chain of 4, and into the next double crochet we are going to work 2 double crochets. So one and 2, then chain of 4 again, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and we are going directly to the next chain 3 space after our group of 4 double crochets. And we are going to make 4 double crochets together. Again, chain 3, double crochet double crochet between 2 groups, so exactly the same as here. Then another chain 3 and another group. 2 chain 4 spaces and 2 double crochets in the middle. So this is our whole pattern, and now we are going to repeat it all the way around. Now we are going to start round number 8 by making slip stitch in first chain stitch and slip stitch in chain 3 space. So our round we are going to start in exactly the same as our previous one. Chain of 2 instead of the first part of the double crochet, then 3 double crochets together. 1, 2, and 3. 4 loops, we can finish the stitch. Now chain of 3. Double crochet into the double crochet, chain of 3, and into our chain space we have to work 4 double crochets together again. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. 5 loops, we can finish the stitch. Chain of 5, 3, 4, and 5, into the first double crochet of our 2 double crochets we are going to work group of first part of the double crochet, then in second one we are going to work 2 first parts of the double crochets. So basically we've got 3 first parts of the double crochets, and when you've got 4 loops we can finish the stitch. Now we've got 3 double crochets together. In first double crochet we've done 1, in second 2. Chain of 5 again. Then we are going directly to the next chain 3 space after our group of 4 double crochets together, and we are going to repeat our pattern from the beginning. So 4 groups of 4 double crochets together, chain 3, double crochet, chain 3, and another group, then chain 5, 3 double crochets together, and another chain 5. Round number 9, we are going to start by making slip stitch in chain 1 space, then first chain stitch, then in chain space. Now chain of 2 as the first part of the double crochet, and then 3 double crochets together. 1, 2, and 3. for loops, we can finish the stitch, chain of three. So again, in exactly the same way as our three previous runs, we are going to start with four double crochets together, chain three, double crochet, chain three, and another four double crochets together. Three and four. Five loops, we can finish the stitch, chain of five, two, three, four, five. Then we are going directly to our stitch with three double crochets together, and we need to work three double crochets together again. So through first two loops three times, one, two, and three. Now we've got four loops, chain of three, and another group of three double crochets together. Through first two loops, one, two, and three. Four loops, we can finish the stitch. So as you can see, we've got two groups of three double crochets together and chain three between. Chain of five again. And we are going to start what we've done from the beginning. So in first chain three space, four groups of four double crochets together. So first group, then chain three, double crochet, chain three, and another group of four double crochets together. So this pattern now we are going to repeat all the way around. Round number 10, we are going to start by making slip stitch in our next three chain stitches. One, two, and three. Then slip stitch in our double crochet. Chain three as the first double crochet. Then into the same double crochet, we are going to work another four double crochets. One, two, three, and four. Now chain of six. One, two, three, four, five, and six. Now we are going to skip our three chain stitches, group of four double crochets together, and another chain space. At the top of our group of three double crochets together, we are going to work another group of three double crochets together. Two and three. Four loops, we can finish the stitch. Now chain of three. Into the chain three space, double crochet, chain three again, then three double crochets together at the top of the next group. So one, two, and three. Four loops, we can finish the stitch. Chain of six, three, four, five, and six. Then we are going directly to our one double crochet, and we are going to work five double crochets in this stitch. One, two, three, four, and five. So now chain of six again, and then three double crochets together, chain three, double crochet, chain three, and another three double crochets together, then another chain six space. And this pattern we are going to continue all the way around. Round number 11, we are going to start by making chain of two instead of the first part of our first double crochet. Into the next four stitches, we are going to make four double crochets together. So through first two loops one time, and the last loop need to stay on the hook. So we've got one, two, three, and four. Five loops, we can finish the stitch, and now chain of eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. So we've done five double crochets together at the beginning, now chain of eight. At the top of our group of three double crochets together, we are going to make exactly the same. So three double crochets together. One, two, and three. Four loops, we can finish the stitch. Chain of five, three, four, and five. On the top of the double crochet, we are going to work V-stitch. So double crochet, chain one, and another double crochet. Chain of five again. One, two, three, four, and five. Then three double crochets together at the top of the next group of three double crochets together from our previous round. Four loops, we can finish the stitch. Now chain of 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8, and we've got another group of 5 double crochets. So from now we are going to repeat what we've done from the beginning. 5 double crochets together, so 1, 2, so each time last loop need to stay on the hook, 3, 4 and 5. Now we should have 6 loops on our hook, because one extra from chain space, and then chain of 8 again, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. So now we are going to work 3 double crochets together at the top of our group from the previous round, chain 5, V-stitch into the double crochet, so double crochet, chain 1 and double crochet, another chain 5, another 3 double crochets together, and then chain of 8 on both sides of our group of 5 double crochets together. And number 12, we are going to start by making chain 1 and single crochet at the top of our first group of 5 double crochets together. Now chain of 6, and then at the top of our group of 3 double crochets together we are going to work another group. So through first 2 loops only one time, and last loop need to stay on the hook. When we've got 4 loops, we can finish the stitch, chain of 3. In our first double crochet of the V-stitch we need to work 4 double crochets, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Chain of 2, then into the chain 1 we need to work V-stitch again, so double crochet, chain 1 and then double crochet again, chain of 2, then 4 double crochets in next double crochet, so second double crochet of the V-stitch, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Chain of 3 at the top of the next group of 3 double crochets together, we are going to work exactly the same. So again, through first 2 loops, one time, 2 and 3. 4 loops, we can finish the stitch, chain of 3 and then chain of 6 now, 3, 4, 5, 6 and then single crochet at the top of 5 double crochets together. From now we are going to repeat what we've done from the beginning. So chain of 6, 3 double crochets together, chain 3, 4 double crochets in first double crochet, chain 2, then V-stitch, chain 2, another 4 double crochets, chain 3, group 3 double crochets together and another chain of 6. And this is our whole pattern. Now we are going to repeat it all the way around. Round number 13, after slip stitching our first single crochet, we are going to start by making chain 1 and single crochet in our single crochet from the previous round. Now chain of 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. 3 double crochets together at the top of our group from the previous round, so we are working through first 2 loops and last loop each time need to stay on the hook. When we've got 4 loops, we can finish the stitch. And now chain of 5. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. We are going to our group of 4 double crochets and now we have to work 4 double crochets together. So through first 2 loops one time and the last loop again need to stay on the hook. So in all 4 double crochets we are going to work the same. When we've got 5 loops, we can finish the stitch, chain of 2. In chain 2 space from our previous round, 4 double crochets. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Chain of 2, then V-stitch in our V-stitch from the previous round, so double crochet, chain 1 and then double crochet, chain of 2, into the chain 2 space, 4 double crochets again, 1, 2, 3 and 4, chain of 2, into the next 4 double crochets, 4 double crochets together, so through first 2 loops 2 times, and last loop knit 2, 1 time only, and last loop knit 2 stay on the hook, so you've got 5 loops, you can finish the stitch, chain of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, then 3 double crochets together at the top of our group from the previous round, then chain of 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, single crochet into the single crochet, and from now we are going to repeat the whole pattern, so chain of 7 again, then 3 double crochets together, chain of 5, 4 double crochets together, chain 2, 4 double crochets, chain 2, V-stitch, chain 2, 4 double crochets, chain 2, 4 double crochets together, chain 5, 3 double crochets together, and then chain of 7. So this is our whole pattern, and now we are going to repeat it all the way around. Now we are going to start round number 14, so at the beginning we need to work slip stitch in our next 7 chain stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and slip stitch at the top of our 3 double crochets together. From this point we are going to start our round, so chain of 2 instead of the first part of the double crochet, then 2 double crochets together, so through first 2 loops one time and then second time again. When we've got 3 loops, we can finish the stitch, chain of 11, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11. Now we are going directly to our 4 double crochets, so we are going to skip chain space, 4 double crochets together and another chain space. Now we need to work 4 double crochets together again, so through first 2 loops only one time, and last loop need to stay on the hook each time. 3 and 4. Now we should have 5 loops. Now chain of 3. Then into the first double crochet of our V-stitch we are going to make 2 treble crochets. 1 and 2. 3 treble crochets in chain 1 space. 1, 2 and 3, then 2 treble crochets in next double crochet. 1 and 2. So we've got group of 7 treble crochets, chain of 3, then 4 double crochets together in next group, through first 2 loops 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5 loops, we can finish the stitch. Now chain of 11 again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11, and now we are going to skip everything, we are going directly to the group of 3 double crochets together, when we have to work exactly the same. So 3 double crochets together. 2 and 3. Now chain of 3, and we are going to skip chain space, single crochet and another chain space. We are going directly to the next group of 3 double crochets. So basically from this point we are going to repeat what our pattern from the beginning. So now chain of 11, then 4 double crochets together, chain of 3, 7 treble crochets, 2 in first double crochet, 3 in chain 1 space and another 2 in next double crochet, then chain of 3, 4 double crochets together, chain of 11, 3 double crochets together, chain 3, and another 3 double crochets together. So this pattern now we are going to repeat all the way around. Round number 15, this is our last one round, we are going to start with 3 double crochets together. So again, we are going to start with chain 2 as a first part of the double crochet, then 2 double crochets together. 3 loops, we can finish the stitch. Now chain of 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Into the third chain from the beginning, 1, 2 and 3, we are going to work slip stitch, so this is our picot. Now chain of 3. And we are going directly to our first treble crochet. Here we are going to make 5 double treble crochets together. So through first 2 loops 3 times. And last loop need to stay on the hook. And now we are going to repeat it 4 more times. So 1, 2 and 3. And again. 1, 2, 3. And again. 1, 2 and 3. And one more time. 1, 2 and 3. Now we've got 6 loops on the hook, we can finish the stitch. Chain of 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Into the third chain stitch from the beginning, slip stitch to make a picot. Chain 3. Into the next treble crochet, another group of 5 double treble crochets together. So this pattern now we are going to repeat in each treble crochet. So we should have 7 groups of 5 double treble crochets together and then chain space with a picot in the middle. So chain of 6, slip stitch into the third chain stitch and then 3 more chain stitches. So at the moment we are going to continue this pattern to the last treble crochet and then I will go back to you to show you what we have to do in next part. So I am at the end of my 7th group of 5 double treble crochets together. So after our 7th group, again we are going to work chain of 6, slip stitch into the third chain stitch, then chain of 3. Now we are going directly to our group of 3 double crochets together and we need to work 3 double crochets together again at the top. So 1, 2 and 3. 4 loops, we can finish the stitch and again chain of 6, slip stitch into the third chain stitch, chain of 3. And then 3 double crochets together at the top of the next group of 3 double crochets together. And from now we are going to repeat our pattern from the beginning of this round. So another chain of 6, picot and then chain of 6. Then we need to work our 7 groups of 5 double treble crochets together with chain spaces and picots after each group and we got then 2 groups of 3 double crochets together and between them chain space with a picot in the middle as well. So this is our whole pattern. Now we are going to repeat it. At the end we need to work slip stitch at the top of our first group of 3 double crochets together, then we can fasten off and cut the yarn. So this is actually end of our project. Thank you for staying with me to the end of this tutorial and see you in the next one. Have a nice day.